Okay, here is our current progress, which is already efficient light detection night time using carbon filter and light detection in daytime. And here is my task, which is carbon detection. And here I actually use lane regression using Ransack algorithm. And basically Ransack is one kind of a regression line fitting algorithm, because due to some noises and some other discontinuity in those lane landmarks and something, we're actually facing some problem like fitting those curb lines for the curb lane detection. So that's why I actually use the Ransack algorithm, and also removing noise from the edge marks, because I actually applied the noise removal part from the edge marks directly, and that's why we're actually kind of removing those kind of noises which can actually kind of confuse the Ransack or the in the later part the gradient threshold and color thresholding parts, in which we can actually able to get a more efficient way to detect the lens. And also partially transform for polynomial fitting, which is the main part of my curb lane detection, because in the curb lane I am actually fitting a second order polynomial in those pixels for those lanes. Okay, so is my process in a flowchart kind of thing. It details how I actually proceed the whole thing in my code. Okay, so first I use color transform and color transformation and gradients etc. to create a threshold binary image, and then I apply perspective transform to rectify binary image and detect the lane pixels and fit to fine boundary. And I know in the previous section we have already done this, but in the perspective transform I kind of use it to make it some manner, we can actually able to fit the second order polynomial, because in our earlier implementation we can't be able to do that. Okay, and in the determined curves, curvature of the lane and vertical position with the respect to center. So basically, it's kind of addition to me, because I actually researched some other code directories and some other paper or something. They actually advise us to get those curvatures and lane vertical positions, but we can actually obviously eliminate them if we want. Okay, and walk the detected lane boundaries back into the original image. So in the perspective transform I'm actually doing that polynomial fitting kind the process, and then actually transforming it back to my original video frame. Okay, result display of the lane boundaries and numerical estimation of lane curvature. That is actually done for the determination of that curvature, and we can actually use it for some other purposes, in the later point whenever we actually want to do some multi-lane detection or kind of vehicle rerouting problem or something. Okay, next slide. Okay, here's the polynomial fitting process in a flowchart manner. So I first calculate a histogram of the bottom half of the image, okay, and partition the image into some horizontal slices. So my basic idea was to I just take a video frame of the main image and just slice it up to some fixed horizontal slices, and then I do the lane detection part. So here part I actually kind of detect those pixels which are actually contributed to the lane marks. Okay, so then I actually fitted I actually use a sliding wheel with a kind of method in which we are actually using a pixel detection thing using those colors, and in that way we are actually detecting those pixels which are actually contributed to the lane marks, and in that way in those original sizes I actually then joining the whole all of those pixels and using a second order polynomial, and in that way I actually get that whole curve lane, and then I actually reverse it back to the its main original video plane. Okay, so this whole process is actually the polynomial fitting process is actually going on into the perspective domain transform of the main video plane, and after we get those polynomial fitted curve, then I actually transform it back to the main image. So then I actually get that curve lane, which is my main goal. Okay, So here is some demo. I actually used this video from the Udacity because like in that video there is a very good curve, there is some good curvature, so I actually use some of their modules, and then I just created that part, and then I just showed my results, and then I actually go into our data set. So here it is. Okay, you can see like there is some problem regarding whenever there is a much curvature in those red lines. In that cases, like it can be able to detect, but whenever there is a small curvature which can be able to fit in the second order polynomial, it can actually really detect good job. Okay, so. And you can also see like whenever some cars or something or some shadows are in that part. So in that cases there may be some kind of fluctuation. So you can see like whenever that car or that bike passes through, there are some fluctuations. Okay. And thank you. And if you have any questions for me.